You know how scientists on TV are always playing with beakers full of brightly colored chemicals? As a biologist, I get to do a lot of really cool things in the lab, but I am a little sad that, unlike TV science, many of the chemicals I use every day are in fact colorless. So it makes me very happy to announce that today we are going to play with beakers full of rainbow chemicals, and the pretty, pretty colors are actually going to tell us something about biology.
We're going to observe this water plant doing two really important cellular processes, photosynthesis and respiration. Let's do a quick review.
In photosynthesis, plants and other primary producers harness energy from the sun to convert water and carbon dioxide gas into sugars, which they use to build their bodies. All this green stuff used to be air.
Plants are so cool.
In the process, they release oxygen, which we humans are very thankful for. In cellular respiration, which all living organisms do, glucose sugars are broken down to make their stored energy available to the cell. Oxygen is used up in this process, and carbon dioxide and water are released along the way. Carbon dioxide is the star of the show today. With its help, we can keep track of both photosynthesis and respiration. That's because carbon dioxide influences the pH, or the acidity, of water. It reacts with water to form carbonic acid, which breaks down into bicarbonate and a proton. pH is a measure of proton concentration. The higher the proton concentration, the lower the pH, and the more acidic a solution is. So, more carbon dioxide in the water results in more protons and a lower pH.
Okay, but what do pretty colors have to do with all this?
Well, we'll be using a color-changing pH indicator to observe the progression of photosynthesis and respiration in our water plant. The indicator is called bromothymol blue, or BTB for short. At pH values below 6, BTB is yellow. Then between pH 6 and 8, it goes through a beautiful color change from yellow to green to blue, with each incremental shade representing a slight increase in pH. And then at pHs above 8, it stays blue. BTB is the perfect indicator to use for our experiment today because pH 6 through 8, where its color change happens, is right around the pH at which most biological reactions occur. When our water plant photosynthesizes, it uses up carbon dioxide. When it respires, it releases carbon dioxide. As we just learned, carbon dioxide affects the pH of the water, which we can observe using the color-changing, pH-indicating powers of BTB. Let's set up our very colorful experiment. You'll need 4 clear vials with tightly fitting lids, tap water around pH 7, bromothymol blue pH indicator, aluminum foil, a pipette, and a water plant. I'm using ceratophyllum, but any aquatic plant will do. Just make sure you aren't using an invasive species. Add an equal volume of tap water to all your vials, and then add the same amount of BTB to each. I'm doing 15 drops from my pipette. It's important that your water has a roughly neutral pH around 7. It should be a green shade. If it's not, you might have to try water from a different source or use an acid or base to adjust the pH. Don't use distilled water though. Your plants will be very unhappy. Next, cut up 4 pieces of ceratophyllum so they're about the same length and put 2 pieces into 2 of the vials, leaving the other 2 empty. We now have 2 empty vials and 2 plant vials. We're going to do 2 experimental treatments, one on each plant vial, and the empty vials will serve as the controls. The experimental treatments are light and dark. So one plant vial will be doing photosynthesis, one will not. To ensure no light can get through to the dark treatment, let's wrap one plant vial and one empty vial in tinfoil. Then put them all near a bright light source. We want to keep the dark vials close by so they experience the same conditions, such as temperature, as the light vials. We're going to leave them here for 12 hours. So, at the start of our experiment, all the vials are the same green color. Based on what we reviewed about the relationship between photosynthesis, respiration, carbon dioxide, pH, and BTB, I'll give you a minute to make some predictions about what the vials will look like at the end of the experiment. What do you think? Now, the experiment as it's currently set up will give us a really nice qualitative look at these metabolic processes. The color change will give us a general sense of what's happening to the pH. But I'm going to add an extra element that will allow us to quantitatively monitor the pH change. Here's an additional plant vial that will stay in the light. I'm going to use a pH meter to precisely quantify its pH throughout the experiment. Let's take an initial reading to see where we're starting off. This is the pH meter. I'm going to place the sensor inside the vial, press take reading, and voila, it's 6.63. Okay, a little less than 7, but still green. I'm gonna put this back in the light and we'll take additional pH readings throughout the experiment, entering the time and pH value of each measurement in a spreadsheet so we can plot the data later. Unfortunately, every time I open the vial to take a measurement, I will let some carbon dioxide gas in, so my readings will be a tiny bit off from the vial that's staying closed the whole time, but it'll still show a useful trend. I can't do this with the vial that's in the dark because exposing it to light would super mess up the treatment, but we'll measure its pH at the very end of the experiment. Now let's go back to our vials and observe what the BTB indicator is doing over the course of 12 hours. Well, look at that. Okay, by the end of the experiment, the light plant vials have shifted from green to a rich blue color. Let's take a look at what happened to the dark vials. All right, look at that. Our plant vial has gotten yellower. And for both light and dark treatments, our empty control vials stayed green. Now let's interpret these results. How did they line up with your predictions? Let's start with the control vials. They're still the same general green color that they started out as, and that's because there isn't a plant inside that's dramatically changing the carbon dioxide concentration and therefore the pH of the water. So let's compare this with our experimental vials. The plant vials in the light underwent a major color shift from green to blue. Why? Well, the plants were photosynthesizing away and using up tons of carbon dioxide. Taking carbon dioxide out of the water makes it more basic, so the BTB turned blue. On the other hand, our plant vial in the dark turned more yellow. All life on Earth respires, and in the absence of photosynthesis, plants will be net producers of carbon dioxide due to respiration. The resulting acidification of the water made the BTB yellower. So that was our qualitative data. Now let's take a look at our quantitative data, which will tell us exactly how much the pH changed and what the pattern of that pH change was. Here are all of the pH measurements I took of the plant light vial. Using Excel, I'm going to plot time on the x-axis and pH on the y-axis. The starting pH was 6.63 and the final pH was 7.59, but the change didn't happen linearly. Instead, we can see that pH increases steeply early on, but then the rate of increase starts to slow and by 7 hours it's leveled off entirely and we don't see a change in pH anymore. This is because the plant was able to photosynthesize rapidly at the beginning of the experiment when carbon dioxide was abundant in the vial, but as it used up the carbon dioxide supply, photosynthesis slowed down and eventually leveled off. I also measured the final pH values of the plant vial in the light that was never opened and the plant vial in the dark. Let's add those points to the plot. Okay, so opening the other vial did have an effect, but it wasn't that bad. Its final pH was only a little lower than the vial that was never opened. And the dark plant vial wound up at 6.35, definitely more acidic than when it started, but overall a lower magnitude pH change than the photosynthesizing plants. This makes sense though, right? Plants, when they're photosynthesizing, are net consumers of carbon dioxide, so we would expect a greater magnitude pH change because they generally use more carbon dioxide than they produce in respiration. Well, I sure enjoyed our pH indicator rainbow exploration of photosynthesis and respiration, and I hope you did too. May all your future science be as colorful as possible.